Good morning and welcome back in this lecture. Today we are going to discuss only about the services which has been provided by internet. Here are certain amount of services which I have written on the board. We are going to discuss on them point by point. First one is www means World Wide Web. There are some of the people used to feel confused that World Wide Web is also known as internet. No, it is a service which is given by internet, because already when we were discussing about the earlier lecture, we have discussed about network. Network says a collection of computer. Network says collection of computer means, when collection of computers means small LAN, MAN and WAN are were connected to form a network, then this network you placed all over the world and formed World Wide Web. Talking about web page and home page, in the last video we have discussed about the difference between web page and home page, where web page is a digital page containing certain amount of data in the format of text, audio, video, animation. Web page, digital page, having data in the format of text, audio, video, animation, etc. And talking about homepage is the first page of a website, which is also known as main page of a website. Moving to the next, web publishing. Web publishing is a tool stand for hosting of a network. Whenever we used to see a website or any web page, we used to store that particular web page or a website on a server. We used to store this web page or website on a server, where a database is being kept for this website. From where it has been hosted, that particular area is known as web publishing. Web publishing is a process from where we can publish a website or a web page. Talking about web browser is a tool which help user to connect with internet. Search engine again a tool which is available on internet. We can use web browser to access a search engine. We are knowing about some search engine just like Google, one of the famous search engine, Yahoo, Nightingale, Bing, Ask. There are many more. These search engine provide a path by which a user can find his data on internet. If you have we look out the internet is just collection of vast amount of data. So to find our own particular data or for which we are looking for, we use search engine. It's a tool which help user to get a proper data for which a user is looking for. Protocol is set of rules and instruction which are being followed by internet for the proper working of internet and for the convenience of user. DNS stands for domain naming system. It is a service which is given by internet for the proper naming of URL or domain of name of a website. Talking about HTTP. HTTP again a protocol. It's a very important protocol because it used to transmit a hypertext data from one web page to another. If you want to transfer your data from one page to another, you need a protocol that is known as hypertext transfer protocol. Talking about URL, uniform resource locator, it's a unique address of a web page by which user can directly access to a desired web page. talking about HTML. HTML stand for Hypertext Markup Language. Stand for Hypertext Markup Language. Here the word hypertext stand for a text wrapping text inside it. Here this word hypertext stand for a text wrapping text inside it. Markup highlighted. Language, a language for communication. This language help user to connect with internet and to connect to communicate their data to internet. Just talking about ISP, internet service provider. These are the company which use to give services to the user so that user can connect to internet. Just like in India, we have Jio, BSNL, VSNL, MTNL, Vodafone and many more. Email, electronic mail. Earlier, we were using snail mail concept. Snail mail concept is also a concept which is also called post office mailing. Nowadays, we are not using this concept. We are using electronic mail in which a user A source have an email address, email ID, and want to send a data or any message digitally to the destination. For that, a destination is also going to have a unique email address, and they can transmit their data within a second. It is low cost, high speed, and many more facilities are being provided by email services. Just talking about email, for making a proper email ID, a user should have a unique, let's suppose take an example of a email address, that is abc@xyz.com. Here abc is also known as a username. Here @ is also is denoting that this username belong to which domain. This @ symbol denote that this username belong to which domain. This XYZ is the name of the domain who is providing this username to the particular person, and .com again a suffix which we have discussed while discussing the URL. This is the suffix. I'm just taking a proper example of an email address, that is abcd@gmail.com. Gmail is not only the company who is providing this email address facility. There are many more, such as Microsoft, or you can move to us, you can move to Yahoo, Bing. There are many companies who used to provide this services. Right now I'm taking an example of Gmail, where abcd is the username of a particular user. This username will be separate for each and every user. Even I have a separate unique address, you have a separate unique address. Then @ is going to denote that this particular username belongs to whom. Now Gmail is the name of the domain who is providing this email address. Then .com is the suffix. Either you can use .com, .in, that is depending on the domain which suffix they are using. Moving to the news group, in the phones or in the mobile phones or television, we used to get a small web slices type content, means a big web. Here you used to get a small web type, slices type content which contained certain amount of news, feeds, RSS which user used to look. Means certain amount of news are there. If you are interested in that, you used to click that, read it out and leave that and move to the next one. So these type of facilities are also being provided from internet. Video conferencing, one of the basic need of nowadays. Most of the people are using video conferencing because within a second you can call a visual call. You can make a visual call to any of the person nearby. For that also you need a unique address followed by the domain. FTP, for transferring the data over internet, we use a protocol that is also known as file transfer protocol. Whenever you want to transmit the data, or even in pen drive, even in memory card, or from one computer to another, from one source to another, you need a protocol that is known as file transfer protocol. This file transfer protocol used to work along with two protocols, that is TCP and IP. Already we have discussed the working of TCP and IP. If you have not gone through, go and watch the earlier videos. Telnet. Telnet is one of the most and basic protocol which has been used nowadays with the armed forces, the doctors and many more. Telnet protocol. Whenever two of the computers are kept at two geographical region, means it is kept at J&K and it is kept somewhere in UP, or you can say in Kanyakumari, or you can say in America, and if you want to connect both the systems together and with a unique address so that you can access any of the computer from any of the location, we need this protocol, Telnet protocol. Whenever we want to connect two computers together which are situated at a two geographical region, we need a protocol, that is Telnet protocol. The best example for Telnet protocol is ShareIt. Sorry, not ShareIt. AnyWeb, or we can say TimWeber. Forum. Forum is a place where the people used to discuss on a particular topic. They used to discuss on a topic. They used to go through the conclusion and get the result. There is one more thing in forum. We used to write personal diaries over internet. If you are writing personal diaries over internet, that are also known as blog or blogger. Blog or blogger can be of two types, personal or public. If you are writing a personal blog, it can be a personal diary which you used to maintain daily, day wise. But if you are writing a public blog, it means you are sharing whatever you are knowing, your public, your interest, your information for the user. That's all for today. We will meet in the next lecture. Thank you.